Which of the two pictures describe the data better? We will find out in today's video. Today, we will be discussing what is descriptive statistics, examples, and three types of descriptive statistics that are frequency distribution, the measure of central tendency, and the measure of variability. Hey champions, if you are interested in these topics, then keep on watching. You can subscribe to our channel for more such videos. So let's start today's video with what is descriptive statistics. As the name suggests, descriptive statistics is all about describing the data. By describing the data, we mean summarizing and graphing it so that it is easier to understand the data. We generally do not reach a conclusion or draw inferences, but just summarize the data. It can be done on both the sample and the whole population. It presents quantitative descriptions in a manageable form. We often use tables, charts, and graphs to present a summary of the data. Now that we know what exactly descriptive statistics is, let's look at one example to understand this concept better. Let us assume that you work for a leading mobile manufacturer and they have assigned you the job of finding the most preferred mobile color. Asking everyone about their favorite mobile color is quite challenging. Hence, you think of surveying 12 respondents about their most preferred mobile color. While surveying, you capture all the responses received in an Excel sheet like this. Now let me ask you, do you think this spreadsheet is informative? Is it providing us the most preferred color amongst the respondents? I think you will also echo my answer that it's an obvious no. On the other hand, let's assume one of your competitors is given the same task and she has presented her data using graphs like these. What do you feel about their report? Can you make out which is the most preferred mobile color amongst the respondents? Before we answer that question, let's compare your spreadsheet with your competitor's graph side by side and see which is more informative. As you can see, the graph on the right side clearly conveys that 50% of the people preferred black colored mobiles, while the spreadsheet on the left was not able to do it. This, my friend, is the power of descriptive statistics. Here, notice that we are using graphs to describe the data and are not drawing any conclusion about the data. I hope this example made the concept easier for you. Now let's move on to our next topic, which is the type of descriptive statistics. There are three common types of descriptive statistics. The first type is the frequency distribution, which deals with the frequency of each value. That is, it tells how frequently something is occurring. It can be used for both quantitative and qualitative data. Moving on to the second type, the measure of central tendency. It estimates the center of a distribution and helps find the middle value or average of the values. It can be further divided into three parts, mean, median, and mode. Mean, it is the average of the values. It is generally the center around which the whole data set is spread. Median, it is the middle value of the ordered data set. And mode, it is the most frequent value in a data set. And the third type is the measure of variability or dispersion. It tells how spread out the values are. That is, how far apart the data values are from the center. They are further divided into various types. First, variance and standard deviation, which measures how spread out the data values are from the mean. Second, range. It is the difference between the smallest and the largest value in the data set. Third, quartiles. These are the points in the data set that divide the data into four equal parts. Fourth, skewness. It describes the shape of the distribution by measuring the asymmetry of the distribution. We will call a distribution symmetric when it looks the same to the left and the right of the center point. And fifth is kurtosis. It describes the shape of the distribution by measuring the tailedness of the distribution. That is, it measures whether the distribution is heavy-tailed or light-tailed relative to the normal distribution. That's it for today's video. We will cover each of these in more detail in our upcoming video. You can share your thoughts or questions in the comment box. Subscribe for more such videos. Bye, and meet you in the next one.